Breaking up with your boyfriend and going over to your best friend's house, and you didn't plan on this before you got over there, but once you were there, you know, you saw him, he's so cute, whatever. And I may ask you questions throughout it, and just answer me as the character, okay? Here we go.
Okay.
And roll tape.
Speak.
And action, retelling the story.
Hi, so, my boyfriend and me, we got into a huge fight. He's always so jealous over me, and we're just always getting into it. I just cannot take his rage and his insecurities. And so, anyways, I finally said enough is enough, you know? I mean, he was always, like, I think he was cheating on me, I'm not sure, but they always say that the cheaters are the ones that are most insecure about themselves. And so, who knows what he was doing behind my back, but I couldn't take it anymore, you know, it was just such an emotional burden for me. So I went over to my good friend's house, and we were just talking and everything, and I don't know, we've been friends for like 6 years, and he's just always been just like a best friend to me, you know, just a guy friend. We never really looked at each other that way. I mean, I've always been a really faithful girlfriend and everything, so I never thought anything would come of what it did. But I got over there, and I guess just from feeling so vulnerable and hurt, he was able to, you know, work his charm, and I realized feelings for him that I had never realized that I felt before. So we ended up, you know, doing the nasty, and it was great. I loved it.
So were you living at your boyfriend's house when all this happened?
I was living with him. What basically happened is I didn't have a place to stay. You know, I just kind of took the clothes on my back. I took a small suitcase with me and my favorite Mr. Oink Oink, and I was like, I just got to get out of here. And so I went over to his place, and you know, he laid out a place for me on the couch. He's like, this is gonna have to do for now. And I'm like, you know, that's fine. I mean, he's always been a really good guy, you know, letting me into his home, and he's always dealt with me and my boyfriend's problems. You know, he's always listened to everything that I had to say.
Does he know your boyfriend?
He does know my boyfriend, and they've actually got into it a few times because everything my boyfriend's put me through, and my friend would always come over and, you know, like, try to play the protector and, you know, save me from the drama. And he's been telling me for a long time to leave him, and I finally took his advice and did so.
JD, quit going just up and down, side to side. On very steady shots, just back and forth, okay? Boom. Always letting her clear the frame. So did you expect that when you went over?
I did not expect it at all. Like I said, we've just been really good friends for a long time. And I guess just from being in that situation, it just made me see things in a different light that I had never seen them that way before. I really wasn't expecting it. I'm glad it happened though. It was great. I mean, I can't believe I've been missing that for all these years. I never looked at him that way, and I don't know why. He's so hot, and it was really great sex. Probably the best I've ever had.
Did he, were you upset when you got to his house going tight, Jake?
Oh, I was really upset. You know, I wasn't thinking about, let me go to this guy's house and get nasty with him. I mean, it's still something that I'm trying to overcome, you know. There's a lot of bad things that happened, and that's still in the back of my mind. After what happened between me and my friend, though, I was able to overcome a lot of things just in that short period of time that we were together. It was such an experience for me.
Jake, and he pop zooms in and out of her, you know, little MTV action. So one more time, Graham, we're through it. Just tell me the story of what, hold on, Jake. Yeah, take it off of auto zoom, and you can do it a little...